Hi, my name is Kazuko ITO. I'm the Secretary General of Human Rights Now. Human Rights Now is a Japan-based international human rights NGO established in 2006. We usually work on the human rights situation in other Asian countries, doing some fact-finding and research investigation and policy recommendation and advocacy. But since the earthquake took place last year, we saw the grave human rights situation in Japan. So we decided to get involved with the human rights aspects of the disaster relief, as well as the human rights situation after the nuclear disaster in Fukushima. So human rights situation after nuclear power plant accident in Japan, I'd like to discuss. So due to the accident in Fukushima, Japan, a huge amount of radioactive materials was released, which is estimated 168 times of the release by the atomic bomb in Hiroshima. So this creates serious risk to the health of the population, in particular, especially mother, child, baby, young generation, most vulnerable. We think it's a human rights problem and grave human rights violation of right to life, right to health, and reproductive health. So current situation, I'd like to tell you, as many citizens in Fukushima still live in a highly contaminated area. Because the government limits the evacuation zone very narrow based on a 20 millisievert per year exposure standard, which is indeed 20 times greater than the previous regulation based on international standard. So this is the response from the government. Right after the accident, the government prohibits the people to get into the 20 kilometer circle of the nuclear power plant. And after this, within the 30 kilometer become evacuation zone. However, beside the 30 kilometer, Japanese government is using a 20 millisievert per year standard to designate area or spot where the evacuation should be recommended or supported by the government. However, this kind of designated area or spot, a very, very small portion of area. So that's why outside the evacuation zone, this is a very wider area with big population, including center part of Fukushima Prefecture, big city like Fukushima or Koriyama, leading city of the Fukushima Prefecture. So in this area, we just sufficient financial support for evacuation from the government. The many people who do not afford to relocate have no choice but stay in contaminated area, even though they may be exposed to health risk. Some family, including children, baby, expecting mother, decide to self-evacuation without government support. But this kind of family, self-evacuation, is minority, not majority. So outside the evacuation area, which is under the 20 millisievert per year standard, the government failed to provide protective measure. For example, government failed to provide free medical check, free medical care, and provide free food from outside. The prefecture government is conducting research of citizen health, but in reality, it just sent questionnaire to ask behavior or activity of each individual after the incident, not asking their physical condition. So no medical treatment followed by the questionnaire. So in terms of decontamination, the government is doing some effort to decontaminate the contaminated area. This is a campaign and the government is mostly focusing on. But so far, almost no impact of the decontamination effect. So local government mobilized ordinary citizens, including pregnant women, to do the decontamination activity, which is very dangerous. So government is not responsible for the decontamination. So just entrust the ordinary people to do the very, very dangerous work. And it's not really effective. Under such condition, people are facing serious risk to their right to life and right to health and reproductive health. And also we'd like to say the withholding the critical information by the government. The following the accident, the Japanese government got estimated data of how the radiation spread out, which direction, and what amount, through high-level computer system speeding, but did not disclose the data to the affected population. Instead, other government provide the data to the US government. Not providing the information to the population, but providing the information to the US government. So without warning, many people run away to the direction of radiation spread out, or stay outside and expose themselves to high-level radiation. And kids are outside, and you know, at the time, there was, you know, the water suspended. So people, you know, seeking for water outside, including children. And plane was falling, which was highly contaminated. So it's quite dangerous. However, no medical checks and no medical care. So currently in the government and also prefecture, safety propaganda is going on. The government conducts no proper guidance regarding the risk of radiation. So instead, there is strong campaign and propaganda surrounding the Fukushima. Okay, please see. So this is a campaign. It's safe. Fukushima is totally safe. No immediate harm. No evidence to critical harm under 100 millisievert per year. This is what the doctor says. And do not be so nervous. Stress will be the most harmful to children. This is a message. Okay. Both national and local government took this position. People who are concerned, the situation become minority, isolated, forced to be silent, and feel hopeless, not encouraged to decide self-evacuation. So people recently get really tired and start to stop protective measures from radiation. So kids play out without any protective measure the outside. That's the situation. So I had a painful conversation of girls. The young girls are living with fear for the future. Can we have children in the future? Safe children, healthy children. Can we even get married? There's some discrimination going on to the girl living in Fukushima. And can we be able to survive and to be adult? That's the voice of Fukushima's girl voice. This is the fear of the girl are facing, but there is no reasonable ground to say their future will be safe. And as an international organization, we studied the international standard. What the international standard is, Japan has already implemented ICRP standard, which is 1 millisievert per year as a domestic standard. So Japan domestic law prohibits ordinary citizens to get into above 5 millisievert per year area, and prohibits pregnant women exposed above 2 millisievert during pregnancy. So current situation, setting up the 20 millisievert per year standard is 20 times higher than the international standard, the standard implemented previous of the accident in Japan. So current situation is breach of both international standard and domestic regulation, which has been applied to Japan. So we also studied about the protection of affected people after Chernobyl accident. So we studied Russian law and former Soviet Union legislation, etc. So we found that the protection of affected people is much better in Chernobyl than Japan. So you can see the exclusion zone was set up 30 kilometer circle. However, the interchangeably, so other three categories have set up to protect the people, affected people. So outside 30 kilometer, in case the radiation level exceeds 5 millisievert per year, population is subject to require evacuation, and citizens have the right to compensate. And radiation level exceeds 1 millisievert per year, this is the C level. The citizens who made the decision to depart in another place to live, so they have the right to be compensated and supported as a measure. So government needs to compensate as well as support for the evacuation. And even if I'm seeing the D, so even as the area that radiation level under 1 millisievert per year, the government needs to realize the complex of countermeasure, which include medical measure for the radiation and radio ecological protection. So I was thinking Japan is much more an advanced country in terms of humanity as well as human rights. However, what we saw as the protection of the people after the nuclear power plant accident, it's shocking, but we found Japan is much worse than the Chernobyl action response by the government of former Soviet Union and Russia. So that's the situation. So you can see the map. This is the map of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. So smallest circle is 20 millisievert. The second smallest circle is 30 kilometer. And the third circle is 80 kilometer. And you can see the, the blue point is the area of up to 1 millisievert area. So it's widespread outside the 30 kilometer circle. So it's a contaminated area. However, no medical check, no compensation, etc. So that's the situation we need to address. So my organization, Human Rights Now, is proposing that the right to compensation and sufficient support for relocation must be provided to the people living in contaminated area exceeding 1 millisievert per year so that they can evacuate. So affected people must be provided long-term medical care as well as clean food. The level of contamination must be strictly monitored and disclosed to citizens in a timely manner. So I also have the recommendation to the international community. So this is not isolated situation in Japan, but universal problem in current world. So this kind of nuclear disaster could happen again, as long as we have nuclear power plants and nuclear weapons. So international community as a whole has responsibility to protect young generation and future generation from such disaster. So we ask international community to closely monitor the situation in Fukushima and make sufficient recommendation to protect the people. Also to establish binding standards and norms to protect women, girls, and future generation from radioactive hazard. And decide to eliminate such risk as a whole. So, no more Hiroshima, no more Fukushima. Thank you very much.